chapter 7, journal proper. We have finished learning, or we have prepared some important subsidiary books or special journals. You also know that journal proper is one of the subsidiary books, and it is the last of the subsidiary books. We have briefly previously discussed as to what would be the recorded in journal proper. So, we say journal proper is to be used when transactions cannot be recorded in a cash book, a purchase book, purchase returns book, sales book, sales returns book, bill receivable book, bill payable book. So, if a transaction cannot be recorded in these seven subsidiary books, it has to be then recorded in journal proper. Let us briefly recapitulate what have to be recorded in journal proper when you are maintaining all the subsidiary books. That is, you are using proper subsidiary books to record all your transactions. So, we say we record opening entries. We record opening entries. Now, you know opening entry is based on accounting equation. It is based on accounting equation. What is accounting equation? You know accounting equation is nothing but capital plus liabilities is equals to asset. Capital plus liabilities is equals to assets. Now, number two, we should record purchase of assets on credit. 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 Then number three, you record what we say sale of assets on credit also. Sale of assets on credit. Then you also record what we say rectification entries. Rectification entries. What is rectification entry? If you know, suppose you have committed some error and you have not yet prepared or closed your ledgers, then we have to rectify the mistake by debiting or crediting some accounts involved in the mistake. So, that journal entry is called as a rectification entry. Next, we have adjustment entries. We have adjustment entries. Adjustment entries are most useful in final accounts. You will learn in detail about adjustment entries when we discuss the topic final accounts. Then we have what we say closing entries. We have closing entries. We have closing entries. We have closing entries, and finally we have something called transfer entries. We have transfer entries. Now, moving on to the next, we will discuss what is an opening entry and what is the other entries and what is the format of your journal proper. So, the format of your journal proper is nothing but it is that of a simple journal. So, as usual, your journal proper format is nothing but that is that of a simple journal. So, you have your date column, you have your particulars column, you have your ledger folio column, and you have your two amount columns. So, this is what you have already learned, nothing great. So, this is what is your format of your journal proper, wherein by you have date, you have particulars, you have LF and a debit amount column and credit amount column.